up, everyone, and welcome to my channel. This is another vlog. We're going to be covering the Jubilee weekend, which I'm not 100% sure what's going on, but I get time off work, so love that for me. I am actually in this outfit, right? Okay, albeit I look a little bit like the dude from Wallace and Gromit, I promise the outfit is cute. I'll show you guys like a full look of it. Like, you need the bag and the shoes to make it look cute. Basically, I didn't have too long to get ready, so I've gone for like straight hair, kind of pinned the back up. I'm not sure if it really looks like that. And I was like, you know what, I'm gonna do red lip, because I feel like when you don't have much time, straight hair, red lip, can't go wrong with it. Not really fake tan, so I needed an outfit that covered me. And this is what I came up with. Regret the red lip, was a mistake. I'm going to go food tasting today, so not sure about the red lip, not sure about the outfit, but I'll show you guys. I'll get Danny to film like a full look. So this is the full look. Let me know in the comments if it's, you know, Wallace and Gromit vibes, or if you think cute. I don't know. So we are gonna head off now. We just did some TikToks. Danny, how was your experience being a TikTok director? Because I had him doing like the flip up, stop starts. Actually, should we show them? I'll show you guys the draft of the video. Like, I'm gonna put some slow-mo on it and stuff, but do you know what? I think we actually went to work. But I think Danny's directorial debut was a smash hit. Also, I kind of did it in character, you know, I kind of did it a little bit like the glamour. I've been posting my TikToks on my Facebook Reels, and I keep getting absolutely annihilated in the comment section. They're like, you're so vain! And I'm like, what about it, huh? This outfit's cute and everything, but a little bit concerned about my bum coming out. Yet so, how could this be done? You're such a smiling sweetheart.
Let me know.
We have just left the food. What would you call it? A food.
It was food festival.
So the view was quite nice, but like the setup wasn't great. So obviously it's outside, it's super windy, which you can't foresee the weather. But there was just like every stall had its own music playing, and it was just like so many different things just like blaring in your ears. But the food was nice, and it was like, it's a cool concept. I just don't think it was very well executed. Also, I managed to get katsu curry on myself. Dan, who ate way more than me, managed to keep a clean sheet, but I'm wearing white. I have katsu curry on my dress. Love that. I was just wandering around the shops. It's like an outlet. Nice shops, but not many places I really shop. But still, we're gonna have a little wander because you know me. If there's a shop, I'll go in it. Have a little wander and then maybe go and get a drink or some food. Also, I absolutely j'adore vlogging in public because everyone just stares at you and it's absolutely incredible scenes. Like, they're just like, I know that you're missing what you never really had. You just do you, and I'ma do me. Give me one last kiss for the road, baby. Good afternoon, everyone. So I'm coming to you extraordinarily hungover today. So yesterday we went out to a food festival to try the different food. The food festival was okay. I think the weather being so bad kind of ruined it a little bit because it was super windy, it was cold, and I feel like it was kind of badly organized as well because all of the different stalls had their own music, but they were so close together you couldn't hear or enjoy anything, if that makes sense. The food was really nice. So the one we went to, the food was really nice. I might go tomorrow. Like, it's not open for as long. Tomorrow it's only open till 4. They've been open till 8, so I might go again just to try that. And also it's a competition, so I want to vote for them. So yeah, the food festival's okay, but we actually ended up moseying around the shops a little bit. I just got this like Champion jumper. It's really cute. It's like cropped, it's super nice. And then we went to a really nice bar, and we were only gonna have a couple of drinks, and then we ended up actually staying up because obviously I have Twitch streams tonight and tomorrow. So it made more sense to actually stay out yesterday, and that was kind of our day off, well, my day off, I guess. So yeah, it was really fun. We went to a really nice bar. The drinks were okay. It was more just very scenic. It was beautiful. Like, I had all like fake flowers and lights, and it was very like Instagram you know, an Instagram situation. I vlogged a tiny bit, but obviously I just had like a night out. I wanted to show you guys a couple of things that I did get on Thursday. Going to the gym and then we ended up moseying around the shops. If you guys don't know, I've recently become like super obsessed with Funkos. I'm gonna do full videos and like full collection videos on my channel. But I had literally just filmed my Funko collection video and then we went out to the gym. Before the gym, we obviously went for like a little coffee, and whilst we were drinking, we were like, let's mosey around the shops then before, because I've worked out in the gym with an iced coffee before and I will never do it again. It was vile. So we were like, yeah, let's just mosey around the shops a little bit. And obviously, you know, Danny's off work, so we're like, oh, lovely. And yeah, I accidentally bought like tons of Funkos and a few other beauty bits, which I'll show you too. And so yeah, I thought I would show you guys what I got. But there's so many Funkos and I can only apologize for my crimes. I got like a bunch of the Eeveelutions. So this was from a shop called Menkind. I didn't even know they did them in there. I've never been in that shop before. I don't know why it's called Menkind, but it's really cool. Like, it's got just loads of like gaming stuff and really fun little tech accessories and Funkos. So that was really cool. And then I also got Jolteon, and then I also got Mewtwo. They had a giant version of Vulpix. So I was like thinking about it, but then I just thought if I was gonna get a giant one, I would wanna get like one of my favorites. So I love Eevee and I love the Eeveelutions, but Vulpix isn't like my top one. So I resisted there. Then I went to Boots. And I really wanted to get some new skincare stuff. So I'm trying the Clinique Combination Oily Skincare. So I've had the Clinique Anti-Blemish before when I was growing up and I loved it then. It really did help my skin. And I've dabbled, you know, in little bits of Clinique here and there and I've always enjoyed it. So I just thought I need to try something new with my skin. Like, a lot of my skincare stuff is running out. I'm due like a refresh. And I've been looking at things online, umming and ahhing, and I thought I'm just gonna go for this. Literally, before I moved here, I had the most amazing facial, and they used the Dermalogica, I think it's pronounced, products. And I got those, and they were working so great with my skin. But when I moved here, they just don't seem to be working as well anymore. And I don't know if it's because it's a different water, it's hard water, and it's really affected my skin. It's actually changed my skin quite a bit. So I'm struggling with skin issues that previously I didn't have. And so I thought I'd go ahead and try this because right now my skin is delivering everything. It's combination oily. Just love that for me. Just can't pick one. Do you know what I mean? Anti-aging, anti-acne. No, we'll just give you a little bit of everything. So I'm going to go ahead and try this. Obviously, it takes a little while for your skincare to kind of see if it's working or not. So I will let you guys know how this goes. Give you guys a little update and review. I'm actually meaning to film an updated beauty favorites because I recently swapped up a lot of my makeup and I'm absolutely loving it. So maybe I'll time that for like a month and then I can show you guys this and tell you how this is going, because skincare is just a journey. It really is. Ooh, also from Boots, I got this pore cleanser and spatula. This was buy one, get one half price. And the reason I got this is because I feel like when I take my makeup off, no amount of cleanser or anything will fully ever remove it. So I'm gonna give this a go. I hope it won't be too harsh on my skin. It feels very soft, so hopefully it's okay. But yeah, I thought I'd give it a go. So again, I'll let you guys know how I got on with it. And then I also got this double-ended face mask applicator because I've recently been getting the Glam Glow ones and they are tiny, and trying to get like your hand in is really difficult. And then it goes like under your nails and it's just grim. And also, like, I feel like it's actually cleaner and there's going to be less bacteria if you use a brush. Obviously you've got to clean the brush, but I feel like that makes more sense than using your hands. Even though you wash them, I just feel like it's still your hands, do you know what I mean? So I also got this NYX purple eyeliner. So you could put this on the waterline. I'm not sure if I do that. I normally put white on my waterline, although it's not great lately. Like, it's not really showing up that much. I thought this would be cool to try to use like underneath my eyes. I have hazel eyes, so purple's a really good color for me. Although I've never really tried this before, and I feel like if you want to try something, NYX is really good because normally their products are pretty good and pretty pigmented, but they're really inexpensive. So for example, if I used this and I decided I absolutely hated it, at least I only wasted like £5 and not like 15. So I feel like if you do want to try stuff and you want to play, NYX is always really good. So I do love a little NYX product. Don't know what that was in my kitchen. And then this, okay, this was an accident. I can explain. So basically, I love Fenty Beauty, so I'm not even mad about what happened. But I was just looking at the Fenty Beauty stuff because I'm obsessed. Some of the recent skincare stuff I've got is from Fenty and it's literally so good. So I was just having a little look and then I took this out because it was in the way. And I was like, oh babes, can you hold this? And then I was just playing with like the sample. And it's a dark brown liner pencil. And I've actually recently got one. All they had was like the glittery brown, which I didn't, it's more of like a bronze. I wanted like a natural dark brown one, but they didn't have it. They only had glittery brown. So I just grabbed that at the time. And I was gonna get this. I just thought, no, like I've really been spending so much lately and like I've been treating myself a little bit too much. Like I need to rein it in. So I was like, you know what? Not this time. Like I just spent quite a lot of money on makeup recently because I needed to refresh everything. So no. And then I completely forgot about it and I didn't even buy that much stuff as you saw. I literally bought like 4 products, but when I checked out and left the shop, I just went in the bag and it was there and I bought it and I was like, oh. And look, could I have easily walked 2 steps back and returned it? Sure, but I just felt like I bought it. It obviously wanted to come home with me, so very excited to play around with this. I had to pop into Primark just to see like their little vases and their fairy lights, but I did see this. It is £11. I went for a size 6. Now, I'm not normally a size 6. I'm normally an 8, potentially a 10. It depends. But Primark, for me, comes up a little bit big. So I went for a 6. Hopefully, I don't live to regret it. I probably won't get into it after this bank holiday, but maybe on the other side. So I also got these 2 Funkos in Primark. They were literally in perfect condition, which is crazy because my Primark, it gets feral in there. Like, things are ripped. I didn't even know Primark did Funkos until I saw one on the shelf, like, completely ripped open. And I was like, oh my goodness, what's happened here? So I got this one. It's for the 50th anniversary and it's Mickey Mouse, but it's like a special glittery one. And I just couldn't leave that there because what I'm trying to do is build like a really nice streaming setup. We're actually moving near the end of the year, so I don't think I'll really get into it in this apartment, but when we move, I want to make like my office and streaming area like really, really cool. And also I do go in there to like edit my videos and work when I don't do it on my laptop, and I like to be surrounded by things that inspire me or just like fill me with like joy. I think it's really important to have an environment where you feel happy. So yeah, I'm gonna build like something really cool, like those strip lights that are like a rainbow and stuff. So I really want to make it like really sick in there, but yeah, that's gonna be a whole other story. And then I got this bell. It's so cute. It's the glittery one. I absolutely love it. And I do want to get Rapunzel because I feel like if I was a Disney princess, I would be Rapunzel. My niece always says Elsa. And the last place that I went was HMV. There were literally so many places with Funkos. Like, everywhere Danny and I went, we were literally like, what? Like, we just keep stopping. And Danny was like, when do I stop? And when do I step in and stop your addiction? And I was like, never. But I got Blossom. And then I got this Harley Quinn one. So if you've seen my other vlogs and collections, I actually already have the Wonder Woman one for breast cancer awareness. I saw this and I couldn't resist because it's such a great cause. And they're actually called Pops with Purpose, which is really cool. If you look into that, they do a bunch of different causes. They've done breast cancer awareness and they've done Make-A-Wish, which I just thought was such a nice thing to contribute to and to get. So I got Harley Quinn and then I also got Blossom, which obviously I want to get Bubbles and Buttercup, but I've never seen them before. I'm trying to grab ones that I've never seen before and try and get ones that are like just a mixture of different things. Like, I don't like to buy too many of the same. I think the most I've got of anything is Pokemon, although I stream Pokemon all the time and it really goes with the things I do, so okay. But other than that, I like to try and get a little mix of everything. It is the Fortnite season finale tonight. I'm not sure when this vlog will be up. I have like a backlog of editing to do on my vlogs. I'm almost caught up, but so I think this vlog's gonna probably go up a couple months after, like a month after. The Fortnite finale is actually gonna be happening tonight and I'm gonna be streaming on my Twitch. It's twitch.tv/MiamiX and I have a video on demand service link down below in case you missed it, which is all completely free to watch, by the way, if you would like to. And yeah, I'm gonna be streaming that, so I'm gonna go ahead and jump into that now. I just want to make sure all the tech is good, everything is like working fine before I jump into it. And then of course I want to get into the lobby at a good time just to make sure I'm there for it. I mean, knowing me, something's gonna go wrong, but we'll try our best. I'll see you guys tomorrow. I am currently signing, so something special. I can't say too much yet. Actually, I'll give you like a sneaky little peek, but you can't know too much. I've done one box, I've got 2 more to go. That somehow came out of there. Now I don't understand how, but it did. I feel like John Cena. Hello everyone, welcome back to the vlog. I know you're thinking, glam queen, I just did a shoot, which I might not have much red lipstick on because I had like a lollipop with it. So if I'm missing red lipstick, I do apologize. You just have to see the shoot because that's where the magic is. So my shoot today, and then I thought I would check in with you guys and vlog with you because I need to do my measurements today for my new gear. So I thought it'd be kind of interesting to show you guys that whole process. I also got some packages, so I thought I'd go ahead and show you them. When we last spoke, it was obviously the Jubilee weekend, which was great. And since then, I've been organizing the apartment. We've actually really had a good go on things, got things really clean. So I'll show you a few bits. But I'm probably in the next vlog gonna literally dedicate that to just doing the apartment. Like, I'm gonna go shopping. I've got like a bunch of stuff from Primark as well, which I'm not gonna show you guys in this vlog. I'll put it in the next one because I'm gonna be like organizing all of like the stuff in the bathroom and my makeup and everything like that. But it's like, I was gonna do it in this vlog, but I feel like it's gonna be really long, so I'm gonna do it in the next vlog. But I do have some packages for you. For the first time in my existence, I've ordered from Meshki. Now, I have seen Meshki, I hope I'm pronouncing it right, so many times on Instagram. It's so nice, and I've just never ever ordered from there before. I only ordered one thing. I was being, you know, conservative. So I only ordered one thing, but it's a hell of a choice that I ordered. Okay, so first impression, I absolutely love the bag it comes in. I'm a wrestler. I store all of my wrestling gear in like these sort of bags because they're so good to put in your case because they're just protected and it's got the little zippy thing on it. If anything was to leak or anything like that, your gear is looked after and it won't click on anything or, you know, be rubbed on and like the design comes off and stuff. Oh, I'm excited. Oh my gosh. No, I'm gonna be sick. This is stunning. So it's just this little, hold on, I've got the straps. There's a lot going on. So it's just this little purple dress. The reason why I liked it so much, right, is because I find it so hard to get summer dresses. Like, I just want one of those light, flowy summer dresses I could just put on. But if a dress is like clings here and is loose, I look like a big box because, you know. So I need something that's kind of like tighter and then flows, but it's hard to find something that's more casual looking like that, if that makes sense. Like, it's always like really corseted and it looks really over the top. This is nice because it's almost like a bit like a baby doll in a sense. Like, it's almost like nightwear, and I feel like it's just going to be really nice because it's got the cups. Obviously the girls are going to look good with the straps, and then it just goes in at the middle and flows out, which I think is so nice. At the bottom it's got this really nice detailing as well, and then the back is just the main event. Like, I think I'd have my hair tied up with this because it's completely backless. Like, I actually adore this. I went for a size small. It looks a tiny bit big off. However, it is backless, so it could be giving that effect because it's not a full dress. So I'm excited to talk to you guys about this. I treated myself to a little iPoly order. Like, I've had some good news with work and I just wanted to do something to treat myself. And I've had this dress that I saw on iPoly that has been on my mind for so long. Like, it's been 2 weeks. But like, I just couldn't stop thinking about it. I saw it and I was just like, it's just so pretty. And I don't know, I just didn't get it because I just don't, you know, I just didn't buy it. Like, I'm so like over my shopping addiction. So I was like, eh. But it's just been on my mind so much. I had this good news. I thought, you know what? I'm going to treat myself. So I got myself a little workout set and the dress. It came to £120 or something. And I was like, what? Like, I did it like I was just doing slow cardio in the gym. So I kind of just, I knew exactly what I wanted. So I went and got it and did Apple Pay checkout. And then I was like, what I thought about it later, I was like, why was it so expensive? Like, did I accidentally order two or something? I didn't. The dress was £65. Now, I'm not stingy. Like, I understand some things are worth more. Like, Opoly have certain things that are like bedazzled or like really, you know, corseted and structured. And I understand why they're more. But when you see this dress, and like, don't get me wrong, the dress is beautiful, it's not special in the sense of like, it's not premium, it's not embellished, it's not a special fabric, it's just like their normal dresses. And you know, back in the day when I shopped on Opoly, they used to be like £35-40, and obviously things get more expensive, but I just thought £65, I was like, what? I mean, I don't know, I kind of want to keep it because it was a treat, but I just feel like the principle of me is like, I feel like I could get the same dress from like ASOS for like £20. I don't even know how to describe this color. It's like a bluey, but it's got purple tones. Like, I don't know, babe, what would you say this color is?
I think it's dark egg.
Dark egg. Do you see why I wanted to get this one though? How nice is it?
Yeah.
He's Googling it. Not dark egg? I feel like dark egg's like green.
Yeah, it's supposed
to be. Or yeah, whatever. It's just like a nice, like almost like a blue with like lilac tones to it. So they had black, pink, this color, and I want to say yellow for some reason. I've got yellow in my mind, and I love the black, but I was like, you know what, I've got a lot of black workout stuff, and then pink, I have the whole Valentine's collection, but this color just stood out to me. I just thought it was such like a beautiful color. And then got the workout leggings. Like, I literally love Bowen T workout leggings. They are just god tier. If you look at the back, look what they're doing for the booty. You know, if you don't have the best leg day, it doesn't matter because they've got you covered. But yeah, I just love the color of it. I love Bow and Tees stuff. So I just got this set.
Gorgeous.
You're really like stuck on.
Oh, no.
Is it the dress? Oh, it is gorgeous. Oh, this is so odd. So it's just this white dress, but the reason I loved it was the corset effect of it. So it's got like a sheer corset around the entire dress, but then it's got like a kind of skirt section and then a bra section, but like the back, as you can see, it's all see-through in this midsection, and I just love the lace up. Now, getting it out of the package, it is really thick. So I didn't anticipate it to be like a really, really thick material. So I can kind of see how it was worth more. I think 50 though, like, what did I say I paid for it, 65? I don't know. Let me know in the comment section what you think. I'm not sure. I do really like it though. I couldn't stop thinking about it. I went ahead and I got it, and I don't know if I regret it, but. Anyway, let me go grab the measuring tape and we will measure for my new wrestling gear. One of many new wrestling gears that are coming to my door. And I got new boots as well. I ordered new boots. They are so divalicious. You guys are gonna die. Like, you know me, my character, the glamour, like I'm all about just having new gear and like bringing fashion into wrestling. So I just feel like you always gotta mix it up. And I have an addiction to gear. I don't know. I have an addiction to wrestling gear. Let's clarify that. But my assistant, Danny Duggan, and I also have my tape. I'm probably gonna have to get undressed for this, so we'll see what we can do. So the thing is with gear, like I always redo my measurements with every gear I get made. So I work with, I think, about 7 or 8 gear makers and designers now. And I just, whenever we're ready to go with the gear, like I always just do it all again, just because your body changes and different designers work differently. Like they need slightly different measurements. So instead of just doing the one for all, like I always redo them just because I feel like it's the smartest thing to do. So Danny, you are gonna do the tape. This is just from Wilko. This was literally like £2 and it's for fashion. So if you need to measure anything, go to Wilko, it's like £2. Get low, who you drive to, cry to. Tell me where the base at. Where the folks with the bag, with the cash in the case at. Tell me where the wealth at. I'ma try to stop that. Tell me cause I want it bad. Alright guys, thank you so much for watching this vlog. I hope you enjoyed it. The Jubilee weekend was so fun and I'm glad I got to show you guys a little bit of my whole process with the wrestling gear. If you haven't, be sure to subscribe because my series, The Making of Mariah May, which is all about my wrestling gear, the designing, the creative process, the inspiration behind everything, and how I came to be the glamour is on my channel, so be sure to check that out. And I'll see you guys all next week or next week and a half for another vlog. And in that vlog, don't forget, I am going to be kind of showing you guys the more finished apartment, I guess. Depending on how successful I am with the furniture shopping, so you guys can get a little look at that. Bye. I'm taking them coins, taking that chain, taking that money, taking that bank, taking them coins, taking that chain, taking that money, taking that bank. Tell me where you slide to. When the life gets high, who you try when the rent do? Tell me who you ride to. When your chips get low, who you drive to, cry to. Tell me where the base at. Where the folks with the bag, with the cash in the case at.